So as we said before, our model is something that we learn from data. Now there are lots of complicated model types and lots of interesting ways we can learn from data. But we're going to start with something very simple and familiar, and this will open the gateway to more sophisticated methods. Let's train a first little model from data. So here we've got a small data set. On the x-axis, we've got our input feature, which is showing housing square footage. On our y-axis, we've got the target value that we're trying to predict of housing price. So we're going to try and create a model that takes in housing square footage as an input feature and predicts housing price as an output feature. Here we've got lots of little labeled examples in our data set. And we're going to go ahead and channel our inner ninth grader to fit a line. We can maybe take a look at our data set and fit a line that looks about right here, maybe something like this. And this line is now a model that predicts housing price given an input. We can recall from algebra 1 that we can define this thing as y equals wx plus b. Now, in high school algebra, we would have said mx. Here we say w because it's machine learning. And this is referring to our weight vectors. Now, you'll notice that we've got a little subscript here because we might be in more than one dimension. This b is a bias, and the w gives us our slope. How do we know if we have a good line? Well, we might want to think of some notion of loss here. Loss is showing basically how well our line is doing at predicting any given example. So we can define this loss by looking at the difference between the prediction for a given x value and the true value for that example. So this guy has some moderate size loss. This guy has near zero loss. Here we've got exactly zero loss. Here we probably have some positive loss. Loss is always on a zero through positive scale. How might we define loss? Well, that's something that we'll need to think about in a slightly more formal way. So let's think about one convenient way to define loss for regression problems. Not the only loss function, but one useful one to start out with. We call this L2 loss, which is also known as squared error. And it's a loss that's defined for an individual example by taking the square of the difference between our model's prediction and the true value. Now, obviously, as we get further and further away from the true value, the loss that we suffer increases with a square. Now, when we're training a model, we don't care about minimizing loss on just one example. We care about minimizing loss across our entire data set.